What's going on, guys? Chinese Guy here. Well, today I am back to do another Battlefield trailer breakdown video, and this time it will be for the Battlefield Hardline Hotwire multiplayer gameplay trailer. And as usual, let's just watch the trailer, and then after I will point out the little details which you may miss since the trailer goes by very, very quickly. Now, I feel like this trailer is packed full of stuff which we might not have seen yet, so hopefully I will try my best to skim through most of the non-important things and just talk about the things you want to hear. So getting started, we have the first shot of a bad guy sneaking up onto the cops, which is ironically going into a donut store, which I know the media loves saying that cops loves donuts, and for any cops out there, hopefully you guys don't get offended. But the most important thing which I have to point out in the shot is not the cops going to the donut store, sadly, but is actually of the different player models in Battlefield Hardline, which I believe they updated. Since the beta, a lot of people felt that the player models were kinda subpar to the past Battlefield games, and I think that one of the reasons why Battlefield Hardline was delayed because Visceral Games actually wanted to add more different player models into the game, and maybe this is the result of having the delay. But overall, the player models looks really nice, they're really detailed, and I feel like if Visceral Games did add an extra layer of customization for the player model, except for the camo, I think a lot of Battlefield fans would be a fan of that, since ever since the beginning of Battlefield, the player models were set in stone and no one could ever change them except for the camo, which was only recently introduced in Battlefield 3. With this next shot, we can get an overall view of the whole map. This is supposedly somewhere set in the Florida Everglades. I'm not exactly sure, but the map looks really, really big, and the reason for that is because there will be multiple vehicles just driving all around, kind of like in a loop. So Visceral Games did have to make these maps gigantic, otherwise basically the vehicles will run out of room. Skipping ahead just a little bit, we can see the criminal on the left popping out of the car is holding, I believe, a new gun which we haven't seen yet in Battlefield Hardline. And if I had to take a guess, I would say this is the UMP9 because it kind of looks like a UMP, but the mag is actually curved, and the only UMP platform gun which has a curved mag so far in a Battlefield game is the UMP9. As we move on in the police chase, we can get a new view of the airboat, which we have seen before a little while back, I believe at PAX when they released a little teaser trailer for this map and this game mode. But now we do officially know that there will be 3 seats for this airboat, 1 driver, 1 gunner, and 1 person that can use their guns and their gadgets. And also to note that RPGs now will officially be battle packs, so we will not be seeing police officers and criminals running around with RPGs because that's not very realistic for a cops and robbers shooter. As the RPG hits the police car, it rolls over and explodes, and during all the explosion and fire, we can see one of the police officer is actually holding the KU-74, which is confirmed to be back from Battlefield 3, so that's pretty exciting news. Again, skipping ahead just a little bit, we can get a nice first-person view of the MP5K. We have seen this gun before in the previous Battlefield Hardline trailers. This time, there's something a little bit weird going on, and that is the total ammo count for the gun. For some random reason, the player has infinite ammo. Maybe it's a glitch, maybe it's part of the game mode, I don't know, but it's probably a bug or glitch. Now, here in this shot, we can get a glance at a new gun, which is, I believe, the Glock 18. Now, the reason why I'm saying this is the Glock 18 and not the Glock 17 or just any other Glock is because it actually says auto on the bottom left hand corner. Usually with pistols, they will only just say semi-automatic and nothing else, but we do know from the past that Glock 18s will usually say auto. As we come near the end of the trailer, we can see the bad guys are chased into a police roadblock with a lot of police officers holding MP5Ks, M16s, and UMP45s. As the gasoline truck drives full on into the police barricade, all the officers open fire. We can get a pretty good close up of what they're holding. The one right in front of us, of course, is holding the 870. The one more to the left is holding some sort of AR-15 platform gun, maybe an M16, again, I'm not sure. And then lastly, we can see a mechanic holding some sort of PDW. I don't know what this gun is, it kinda looks like a bigger version of the Tech-9, I don't know. If you guys have any suggestions, please leave them down in the comments below because I would really like to know what this gun is. Here again, we can see a different mechanic firing the MP5K. And lastly, I want to quickly point out as the gasoline truck ran through the barricade, for some random reason, the truck doesn't explode, which is kind of odd to me because I'm pretty sure the truck is full of gasoline, so maybe it's just for the trailer that the gasoline truck doesn't explode so it can create some kind of cinematic event. Anyways, that about wraps up this trailer breakdown. Hopefully you guys noticed something new about this trailer through my video, and hopefully you guys enjoyed the video itself. Make sure you leave a comment down below of what you think about Hotwire, because personally I am kind of looking forward to this game mode. I think it will be a very nice switch up from the infantry play which we will be getting a lot of in Battlefield Hardline, and Hotwire will probably be more of a vehicle centric type of game mode. Thanks for watching, peace out guys.